Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Friday of the second week of Easter. Our Mass Presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphone. You have redeemed us, Lord, by your blood, from every tribe and tongue and people and nation, and have made us into a kingdom, priest of our God. Alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, hope and light of the sincere, we humbly entreat you to dispose our hearts to offer you worthy prayer and ever to extol you by dutiful proclamation of your praise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. A Pharisee in the Sanhedrin named Gamaliel, a teacher of the law, respected by all the people, stood up, ordered the apostles to be put outside for a short time, and said to the Sanhedrin, "Fellow children of Israel, be careful what you are about to do to these men. Some time ago, Theudas, claiming to be someone important, and about 400 men joined him, but he was killed, and all those who were loyal to him were disbanded and came to nothing. After him came Judas the Galilean at the time of the census. He also drew people after him, but he too perished, and all who were loyal to him were scattered. So now I tell you, have nothing to do with these men, and let them go. For if this endeavor or this activity is of human origin, it will destroy itself. But if it comes from God, you will not be able to destroy them. You may even find yourselves fighting against God." They were persuaded by him. After recalling the apostles, they had them flogged, ordered them to stop speaking in the name of Jesus, and dismissed them. So they left the presence of the Sanhedrin, rejoicing that they had been found worthy to suffer this honor for the sake of the name. And all day long, both at the temple and in their homes, they did not stop teaching and proclaiming the Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
One thing I seek, to dwell in the house of the Lord.
One thing I seek, to dwell in the house of the Lord.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom should I fear? The Lord is my life's refuge. Of whom should I be afraid?
One thing I seek, to dwell in the house of the Lord.
One thing I asked of the Lord, this I seek, to dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, that I may gaze on the loveliness of the Lord and contemplate his temple.
One thing I seek, to dwell in the house of the Lord.
I believe that I shall see the bounty of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord with courage, be stout-hearted, and wait for the Lord.
One thing I seek, to dwell in the house of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia. One does not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes forth from the mouth of God. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus went across the Sea of Galilee. A large crowd followed him because they saw the signs he was performing on the sick. Jesus went up on the mountain, and there he sat down with his disciples. The Jewish feast of Passover was near. When Jesus raised his eyes and saw the large crowd was coming to him, he said to Philip, "Where can we buy enough food for them to eat?" He said this to test him, because he himself knew what he was going to do. Philip answered him, 200 days' wages worth of food would not be enough for them to have a little." One of his disciples, Andrew, the brother of Simon Peter, said to him, There is a boy here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. But what good are these for so many? Jesus said, Have the people recline. Now there was a great deal of grass in that place. So the men reclined, about 5,000 in number. Then Jesus took the loaves, gave thanks, and distributed them to those who were reclining, and also as much of the fish as they wanted. When they had their fill, he said to his disciples, Gather the fragments left over. So they collected them, and filled with 12 wicker baskets with fragments from the 5 barley loaves that had been more than enough that they could eat. When the people saw the sign he had done, they said, This is truly the prophet, the one who is to come into the world. Since Jesus knew that they were going to come and carry him off to make him king, he withdrew again to the mountain alone. My dear brothers and sisters, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So, as we mentioned yesterday, today we transition into a new section of John, and a new topic, no? That eventually the Gospels will lead to the discourse on the bread of life, no? So here you have the multiplication of the loaves and fish in John, no? In the Gospel of John. And maybe just to reflect on 3 things, no? Again, to go back to that definition of vocation or mission that we have shared over the years, no? That meeting point between a deep hunger of the world and our deep gladness or joy, no? And then the second point that we will reflect on here, you see now, no? Partly what we were talking about yesterday, remember, about the abundance of God's grace, no? But here you have 2 people with different perspectives about God's grace, no? You have Philip, who will say, no matter what we do, no? Nothing can resolve the problem or the issue. And then you have Andrew, no? And then the third and last point that we will reflect on is that, again, this gospel really is a prefiguring also of the Eucharist, no? So that's the last point that we will reflect on. Of course, because after this also is the discourse on the bread of life, no? First, about the hungers of the people, no? You know, when you take a look at the ministry of Christ, no? And this particular gospel, you realize that the Lord, by and large, no, responded to 3 hungers of the people, no? Number one was their thirst to hear the word of God, no? To be enlightened about God's word, no? And then their thirst for healing, no? So that was also part of the thirst, no? So when you look at it, it's a spiritual thirst, it's an emotional thirst, it is a physical thirst, no? And then here the Lord addresses, no, another hunger, the physical hunger, no? Food. And I think, again, that brings us back to that definition of vocation or mission, no? What is our mission? Where is God calling us to? What is our vocation? It is the meeting point between our deep gladness and a deep hunger of the world. And we saw that very clearly in Christ, no? That his deep gladness was to fulfill the will of the Father. His deep gladness was to be obedient to the Father, to be the beloved Son, no? And the hunger that he responded to was that people were looking, no? Were looking for the Messiah, were looking for enlightenment, no? For teaching with authority, no? For healing and expelling demons with authority, no? So there was that meeting point, no? And we see that in the gospel for today, no? And then the second point that we will reflect on is the 2 principles, no? That we can take on when we face a crisis, no? Clearly, this was a crisis, and the crisis was something also that the Lord heightened by asking his disciples, so what do we do? No? And you have Philip who said, no, we can't do anything. It's impossible to be able to resolve this problem of feeding this 1,000. We have 5,000 plus, no? So Philip said that. The 200 days wages, which I guess they do not have, no? Will not be enough to feed them, no? And then you have Andrew who, as we mentioned, no? Brought the little boy with 5 loaves and 2 fish. But you realize it's really funny how he brings the boy and also doubts, no, what can this do anything? But he tries to present a solution, no? So here you have 2 attitudes, no? I think 2 attitudes towards God and towards grace and towards life in general, no? One is that you see life, as we said before, no? you see a glass that is half empty, no? That's the Philip mindset, no? And then Andrew, you see the glass as half full, no? It's a stance towards life, no? And of course, one of the things that is nice to remember what we said. I was sharing with you that I attended the seminar way back in 1994 in Boston College, no? It was a seminar on lay collaboration, because it talked about how at that time, no, that even up to now, no, that there is now a lack of religious and priests, no? So it is really a time of scarcity, no? And yet, during that time of scarcity, it is precisely where the grace of God enters, no? The superabundance of God's grace meets human scarcity. And here you have that, no? As Andrew brings the poverty of the situation, no? A boy with 5 loaves and 2 fish, that allows the miracle to happen, that allows God's superabundance of grace to take effect. So that second point to reflect on, a very powerful point actually, no? Do we bring the poverty of who we are, the poverty of ourselves, no, the limits of our human capability, to bring it to Christ, to bring it to God, and to allow the superabundance of God's grace to take over and transform the situation? So that is the second point that I invite you to reflect on, no? And then the third and last point is the prefiguring of the Eucharist, no? And here, of course, you this will come up again, no, in the coming days, no, the next week actually, no, the whole of next week will be focusing on that, leading to the discourse on the bread of life, no. But here you have the prefiguring of the Eucharist, no, as the gospel tells us, he took, he blessed, and he gave, no. Of course, in the Eucharist we repeat that, no, he took, he gave thanks, he blessed, he broke, and then he gave, no. And I guess this is again an invitation for us, no? An invitation for us how to live our lives, no? If our lives if it's meant to be lived in mission, most certainly this is one of the patterns of mission, the Eucharistic pattern of grace, no? To take stock of our lives, to be self-possessed. And because I think it is only when we are self-possessed that we're able to offer, no? And that bridge between integrating ourselves, becoming self-possessed, is gratitude. And out of gratitude, we are able to offer and to commit, no? To take, to give thanks, to break, that's offering, and to give service. So today, let us reflect on this, no? Pag nilaya natin itong ebanghelyo ngayong araw, ito yung simula ng isa na namang bahagi ng ebanghelyo ni San Juan, no? Ito magtatapos sa darating na Sabado, no? Sa isa, hindi bukas, sa isang Sabado, doon sa yung sukdulan, yung climax, yung discourse of the bread of life, no? At makikita nga natin dito na pinapakita rin dito na ang Panginoon tumutugon sa mga kagutuman ng tao. Sabi natin, di ba, ano ba ang misyon, ano ba ang boksyon, ano ang tawag ng Diyos sa atin? Kung saan nagtatagpo ang ating pinakamalalim na kagalakan at ang isang uhaw o gutom ng mundo, yun ang mission natin. Doon tayo tinatawag ng Diyos. At makikita natin to sa Panginoon mismo, no, na ang mga tao uhaw sa salita niya, uhaw sa paghilom, uhaw sa pagpapalayas ng demonyo, pero uhaw sila sa pagtuturo at isang tao na may otoridad, no. Uhaw sila doon. At dito makikita mo, tinutugon na ng Panginoon yun. Isang pagtugon sa kanila mga emosyonal, espiritual, at ngayon dito sa Ebanghelyo, yung physical na gutom, no. At siguro mahalaga na balikan natin to, na ito'y bahagi rin ng pagninilay sa ating misyon, no. Ano ba yung mga gutom o uhaw na tinutugunan natin, no, sa ating buhay? At yung pangalawang punto ay yung papel ni Felipe, ni Philip at ni Andrew, no, ni Andres, no. Na makita mo si Felipe, sabi niya, hindi natin to kaya. Kahit meron tayong pera na 200 araw ng trabaho, hindi pa rin mabibigyan ng sapat ang mga tao. Si Andrew naman, nagdala ng isang bata, may limang pirasong tinapay at 2 isda, no? At makikita nyo yung dalawang punto de vista, no? Pag panahon ng krisis o pangangailangan, ito ba ang magiging kagaya ba tayo ni San Felipe na ay yung baso, ano yung kalahati, walang laman. Si San Andres, hindi, kalahati, puno. Oh.
Pero tandaan natin na hanggat hindi natin inaalay, no, ang karukhaan ng ating sarili, ang pagkarukha ng ating diwa at ating sarili, hindi magaganap ang milagro, ang himala ng Diyos, ano? Dahil dinala ni Andres itong batang ito, naging posible, no, ang himala ng Diyos. Sabi nga nung pinuntahan kong isang seminar, 1994, ano, sa Boston College, sabi nung nagbigay ng seminar tungkol sa lay collaboration, sabi nila, ang biyaya ng Diyos ay lumalabas yung ano niya, ang ganda ng term niya, super abundance of grace. No? Yung talagang nag-uumapaw na biyaya. Sabi niya, yan ay sisipot pagka inaabot na natin yung sukdulan ng ating kakayahan na hindi na natin kaya. Kaya iaalay na natin sa Diyos yung karukhaan natin at doon papasok ang biyaya ng Diyos. No? Napakagandang imahen. No? At yan din yung nangyari sa Ebanghelyo ngayon. Dahil dinala ni San Andres, no, yung karukhaan, ano, at yung pagkamahirap, no, ng ating sitwasyon bilang mga tao, nang naganap, no, ang bukas palad na pagbubuhos ng biyaya ng Diyos. At yung mga tutuling punto ng ating pagninila, itandaan natin, ito nga ay sinasalamin ang Eukaristiya. Sabi nga, ating kunin, pasalamatan ng Diyos, at paghati-hatiin at ialay sa kapwa. Yun yung imbitasyon din sa atin.
In the miracle of the feeding of 5,000 people, our Lord shows us the Father will give us everything we need. Let us ask Him for all the good things He can provide us.
That the leaders of the church may show the same compassion that prompted Jesus to feed the hungry crowd, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Christians may imitate the young boy and share what they possess with the underprivileged, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That young people may find Christ as the satisfaction for their thirst and hunger, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. And we pray most especially for the Holy Father, for his good health. We pray for all his intentions, especially for his prayers for peace. And we continue to pray for the coming Synod on Synodality. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Accept in compassion, Lord, we pray, the offerings of your family, and under your protective care, they may never lose what they have received, but attain the gifts that are eternal, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, the universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together an unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father most holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you," Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now, let us offer our prayer for Easter.
Risen Lord, may the joy of this season inspire us to renew our friendship with you as your companions in mission. Open our mind, heart, and spirit to the truth and grace of sacred scripture, and may the story of the journey of your disciples and the early church renew our own journey of mission in our world today. Enliven our faith that we may do all things in joyful, loving obedience and witness to the saving power of your cross and resurrection. May we be a sign of hope in our world today and bring the victory of your cross and resurrection over the evil of violence, injustice and war, over sin and death. Risen Lord, make our hearts burn within us that we may set our world on fire with the love and mercy of your heart. Amen.
And let us pray. Keep safe, O Lord, we pray, those whom you have saved by your kindness, that redeemed by the passion of your Son, they may rejoice in his resurrection, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Maraming pong salamat. And please again join us for Journeys of Hope this weekend. Our guest is one of the talents of ABS. No? Young and one of the young talents. So coming out soon, I think, in a teleserye, no? Emilio Daes, no? Then also, sorry about the Proyecto Pilipino. There is a new episode, no, that some of you might have seen. So please join us for Journeys of Hope and also Proyecto Pilipino this weekend. No? Now, Proyecto Pilipino is in the YouTube channel of the Conscience Collective, no? Whereas KDM and the Kapamilya Daily Mass and Journeys of Hope is in the My Prayer channel. So please join us, and also it's going to be shown in the cable channel. So maraming pong salamat and have a good weekend ahead. Thank you po.
I can't feed 5,000, but I can feed one. I can't walk in water, but I can walk in the shoes of another. I can't turn water into wine, but I can turn a frown into a smile. Sharing what I have in my hands is the miracle that needs to be seen today. Every blessing I receive is a miracle that I can share. This is what I can share. This is my Alay Kapwa.
Alay Kapwa, a flagship program of Caritas Philippines by the Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines.